If your father was a former semi-pro Dota player, you'd think, hey, I think my parents are gonna let me be a professional gamer.
My mother was really mad and she said they're gonna call the cops.
Okay, so maybe not every professional gamer has their mother threatened to call the cops on them just because they were playing Mobile Legends. It's true, by the way, but that's not the whole story. In fact, we'll just let Mobile Legends pro Kairi tell it. It's pretty incredible.
So there was a smart tournament in Bataan, so the championship prize is 10,000 pesos. So after the tournament, because two of my teammates were from Manila, right, then I secretly go to Manila from Bataan with my friends, and I didn't tell my parents because both of my parents were in other country. They were working abroad.
So how did this young teen get permission to travel all the way to Manila for a gaming tournament?
I downloaded an app. It's like fake messenger. So I edited my mother's name and my mother's picture. Like I told my mother in there, like, Mom, I want to go to Manila, like that. And I replied to myself using my mother's name and my mother's picture. I said, like, yeah, okay, I'll let you go to Manila, like that. My mother asked my other grandmother, like, where am I? Then they contacted my uncle from Manila. My mother was really mad and she said they're gonna call the cops to get me from Manila to Bataan.
So why did Kairi go to such lengths to play in these MLBB tournaments? And why did his mom have such a big reaction to it? Turns out, Kairi isn't the only gamer in the family. Kairi's dad actually dabbled in amateur tournaments for Dota back in the day. Although his dad's dreams didn't come true, it definitely shaped the way Kairi looked at gaming. In fact, gaming was a part of his life even if he didn't have things like internet or even a device of his own yet.
I was only like watching my classmates and how they play because that time I didn't have a cell phone. I didn't have my own cell phone, so, and we didn't have Wi-Fi, so sometimes I use my grandmother's iPad so I can play there, and the Wi-Fi that I was using was our neighbor's.
His mom, though, wasn't too impressed. She already knew that gaming didn't pan out for Kairi's dad. Plus, Kairi wasn't too enthusiastic about school, and so Kairi's mom had little reason to buy into the obsession with gaming.
So I always tell my mother that I can also earn a lot of money by just playing games, but at first they were really not supportive.
As the tournaments got bigger, Kairi's mom grew more and more uncomfortable with this growing hobby. It must have felt like deja vu for her, seeing another member of her family fall deeper and deeper into gaming with no certain future. But in today's world, esports as a career is a possibility for Kairi, especially when one of the biggest Mobile Legends teams in the Philippines comes knocking.
I stopped playing for like 1 month, then Coach Bonchan from Blacklist International messaged me. He told me to if I wanted to try out for the team because they were looking for a jungler that time. They contacted my mother when I already passed the tryout. If I can like join the Blacklist, I will have like salary. We're gonna have a boot camp like that. I think my mother's point of view since that time changed because there's actually a company that's gonna look out for me.
With an offer like that, Kairi's mom finally gave him the go signal. Kairi joined Blacklist International in MPL Season 6 as their jungler, his biggest shot at the dream he always wanted.
My name is Kairi Reislensen. Sa mga kalaban namin, good luck sa inyo. Gagalingan namin.
As Kairi began experiencing new highs and new lows in esports, other opportunities also began presenting themselves.
Years ago, when I first started MPL, I didn't see myself like becoming one of the world's best jungler like that. Back then, I was just like, I was just trying to do my best. I just wanted to win. I didn't see myself like going this far like that, going to play for other country. I mean, for other teams in other country. The first time I got the offer, I was really sure that I don't want to go to other country, but since Coach Sheb talked to me, like, we two of us, like the Onyx ones, the two of us, like, since that time I made up my mind that I also wanted to try, but I was sure that I cannot do it alone. So I think Coach Seb was the most that convinced me to move to Indonesia.
Kairi became the first Filipino player to be recruited into MPL Indonesia. The young MLBB star garnered multiple awards during his first season on MPL ID, including the Finals MVP. But unlike his early days of impersonating his mom, Kairi today is more focused yet humble and hungrier than ever to prove himself.
I don't think I'm gonna get comfortable just by winning. Like, I don't think I'm gonna get satisfied just by getting a lot of personal awards. Even if I'm on the top, I can still learn a lot from the people at the bottom. Because, yeah, you cannot stay the strongest all the time. But you can always learn.
Ooh, so who else will be watching Kairi's career with great interest? He's only getting started. If you want to learn more about Kairi's former teammates, you might like these videos.